name is Lerato. Welcome to the next topic in our gentle introduction to GIS series. In this topic, we will look at attribute data. In our last topic, we looked at vector data and discovered that vector features have a geometry and attributes. While the geometry of a feature defines its shape and position, the purpose of attribute data is to describe features. Imagine if every line on a map was drawn with the same color. It would be very hard to see what is going on. We can color maps because we know things about the different features they represent. For example, we know this is a secondary road and that this one is a track. Drawing them in different colors helps us to make sense of the map. It is the attribute data that provides the information we need to obtain the meaning from maps. Every feature has characteristics we can describe. For example, this house has properties such as roof color and a balcony, which helps us to describe it. Attributes can also be things we know about the house but can't necessarily see. For example, we may know the year in which it was built. The attribute may also be the absence of a property, such as this house has no balcony. While we look at the geometry of features in the map view, we look at their attributes in a table view. Each different attribute is shown in the table view as a column or field. Each row in the table view represents one feature. Table rows are also known as records. Clicking on a row in the table view will highlight that feature on the map. The fact that the GIS application knows what attributes each feature has opens up many possibilities. Using the attribute data, we can tell the GIS application to draw our features based on their attributes. For example, we can color code these house polygons based on the color of their roofs. Or based on whether they have a balcony or not. We can also use the attribute data to create labels for features based on a property. The attributes are also useful because they enable us to search for features. If you ever spent hours looking for something on a paper map, you will realize how useful this capability is. In our next screencast, we will continue the topic of attribute data by looking at symbology that can be defined based on attributes. Thank you. See you next time.